In this video, we will try to fit a histogram with a Gaussian function. And this is the histogram, and this is the Gaussian fitting of this histogram. So in order to do this thing, let's first go to the data. And our data points are actually on the x-axis, we are having the diameter of nanoparticles, and here on the y-axis, we are having the count of those nanoparticles. Here we can see that our maximum number is actually here. The 3.5 nanometer nanoparticles are in abundance here. But the Gaussian distribution will give us a perfect idea. So start, select the data and go to a column plot. So by clicking the column plot, I have plotted the data, and now let me maximize this one, as we need it to be more visible. Now these are the counts. I can change the pattern of them. If I select here, inside the color I say no color, and here I select the pattern as sparse, and I apply this one. So I'm having the columns like this. Now I can change the pattern color, and the pattern color, let's say I mark is blue, and now my data point, my column bar is like this. Now I would like to fit this with a Gaussian fit, because normally the nanoparticle distribution we fit with a Gaussian fit. So here, let's go to analysis, and then fitting, and then nonlinear fit, and then open dialog. And here we select our functions is the Gaussian function. And as I click the Gaussian function, then I see the preview of this one. And the Gaussian function is the same as we discussed earlier. So let's click one iteration, and I can see that it is fitting very well, and just click fit until converge. So it has done the fitting, and now I go to the parameters, and the parameters are here. Now here in this fit, the value, although it is less, but in a bar graph, this is giving the right value, because here I want just to check the distribution of my nanoparticle, and the distribution of nanoparticle should come inside the standard deviation. So if I look at the width of this one, then the width here of this curve is lying under 3.2 nanometer. So 3.2 nanometer is comparatively a better value. So I will go on with this plot. So let me delete this one, and here this detail we can find anytime here, while the plot of the curve is actually here, the x-axis and the y-axis. So we can copy the data from here to anywhere we would like to shift this distribution. Here I just click the Gaussian fit, and the data is like this. So just change this one a little bit, the width of it. Let's say it is 3, and we are having the fit like this. So we can fit a bar graph as well with a Gaussian fit. If our values will be like this one, then it is an exponentially decaying function. But normally the nanoparticle, we want to see their size distribution, and their size distribution can be fitted very well with a Gaussian fit. Thank you for watching.